Praise God. Praise God. Let the people of God say amen. Amen. I welcome you to the Bread Broadcast, a Bible teaching program where we edify, we exalt, and we challenge believers to the Great Commission. Here, we also call sinners to salvation through the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you for joining us. Today, we are going to the second part of a three-part series, Unmasking Our External Enemy. Unmasking our external enemy, the world system. And the case study is one of my best Bible characters. Each time I read about him, I learn from him and he encourages me. His name is Prophet MICAIAH. Prophet MICAIAH. And your short reading is going to be 1 Kings chapter 22, verse 7 to 27. 1 Kings 22, 7 to 27. Let us pray. Father, we thank you. Oh, in all situations, all the time, you are good and you are true. So, Father, through our Lord Jesus Christ, by the Holy Spirit, we declare that you are God and that you're good. Even when we have to sorrow, even when we have to cry, you are still God. And we thank you. Thank you, O Lord, for this Bible lesson. O Lord, I pray that you walk through my pain to reach the heart of people in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father God. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Our foundation text is James chapter 4, verse 4, the epistle written by the brother of our Lord, Apostle James, chapter 4, verse 4. Adulterers and adulteresses. This is somebody who is a believer, but is now going after the things of the world. It is making the things of the kingdom about God secondary. Those are the people that the Bible calls adulterers and adulteresses. These are spiritual adulterers and adulteresses. Do you not know that friendship with the world is enmity with God? Whoever therefore wants to be a friend of the world makes himself an enemy of God. So last week we talked about recognizing our internal enemy, the flesh, our proclivity to sin. Today, we are talking on masking our external enemy. How do you recognize the world? Now, when I say the world, I'm not talking about people. I'm not talking about trees and mountains. We are talking about the world's values. Right? The world values. How do you recognize the world? Number one, the world is inviting. The world values has its way of advertising juicy rewards if you join in. Follow me slowly. The world system is more faithful. Listen to this. In converting people to its ungodly way than most Christians are. You see, the world system insidiously uses a seemingly good reward for undetected evil practices. Let's see some example. A shrewd and greedy business person what amassed wealth is respected and called noble in the society, you see. A shameless person, yes, a shameless person who does not care to parade his or her nakedness in front of millions of people in cinemas, and they even do abominable things on screen, they are called actors or celebrities. you see. And they are rewarded with lots of money and fame, you see. An individual who is very good at lying, and we have many of them in Congress, they are called savvy politicians, you see. The world does not recognize or applaud someone for being a faithful husband. When was the last time that you hear the Emmy goes to John Doe, the plumber, for being a faithful man to his family, to his wife? Huh? Those are not celebrated. When was the last time that they announced and the Oscar goes to Jane Doe, who is a committed housewife and a mother caring for a special needs kid? They don't care, you see. The world system does not celebrate things like that. But if it's lewd, if it's lascivious, if it's ugly, sensual or sexual, they will celebrate it, you see, and reward it. A follower of Christ Jesus who shuns the world's values is seen as stupid, narrow-minded, and boring, you see. Ahab did not like Micaiah for prophesying the truth. Micaiah was excluded from the party because of his godly values. Just like Joseph's brothers hated him for giving their father a bad report about them. Let's go to the book of Proverbs, chapter 14, verse 9a. Proverbs 14, 9a. Fools make a mockery of sin. You see, when people are laughing at adultery in the cinemas, they are laughing at fornication, the Bible calls them fools. Or they do commercials where people are lying, and they call that commercials. Really? Proverbs 10:23. It is a sport to a fool to do mischief, but a man of understanding hath wisdom. You see, the world thinks you suffer if you refuse its offer. If you're a child of God, people look at you like you are missing out on the party. They got it wrong. They are the ones missing out on the party, you see. So if anybody is telling you that you are missing out, as a child of God, you look at them and say, no, you're the one missing out. The world thinks you suffer if you refuse its offer. Moving on. Another way you recognize your external enemy, that is the world system, is that it's infectious. The world's single objective, listen up, track with me, is to conform you. That's it. And because, listen up, human beings, we are naturally created to have relationships. Nobody likes to be alone or be left out. You see. So because of that, the world uses the power of bandwagon to convert people to its ungodly values. Those who derive biblical values tend to be more prominent and celebrated in the society. This demonic deception makes godless values look attractive and widely accepted. Unless a believer is firmly rooted in constantly studying the Word of God and surrounding yourself with like-minded believers, that believer risks being infected with the world's godless values. When Simon Peter hung out with the wrong crowd, guess what? He denied the Lord. Samson moved with the wrong crowd. He ended up on the laps of Delilah. And that became his undoing, you see. Let's go to 1 John chapter 2, verse 15. And when we say the world, we are not talking people. is the world's values, their godless values. If you're a Christian, listen up. 1 John 2:15. Love not the world. That's a command. That is godless values. Do not love it. Neither the things that are in the world, that is the latest trends. You see, people, they like to pile on to say bad stuff about some people, leaders in the country. You don't have to join them. No. As a believer, that's none of your business. You pray for our leaders, the Bible says. No, don't join them because it's trendy. No. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him, you see, or her. The world's reward for its own is the tool of its pull to be owned. If the world should pull you to its side, which is fake rewards, the world will own you. The world's reward for its own is the tool of its pull to be owned. Moving on. Now, we have talked about the word being inviting, being infectious. Let's see the third way you can recognize the world's values. It's intimidating. The world is intolerant. Please listen up because we need this in the United States right now. The world is intolerant of a dissenting voice or contrary beliefs to theirs. A lot of people will not be able to stand what I'm saying right now. Why? Because I dare to stand on the opposing side of their world view, you see. That's the world system for you. This intolerance has nothing to do with an individual believer. So if you're a Christian, if you're the only believer in your workplace or in your family, and they hate you, they don't hate you. They hate the godly values that you are carrying, okay? The world's problem is with the godly values that we embrace as disciples of Jesus. Biblical values, listen up, convict the world, condemns the world's system of operation, and also confront the world by reminding them that a day of reckoning before the perfect holy God of the Bible, that day is coming. In Babylon, anyone who prayed to God was threatened with being thrown into a lion's den. This was to silence, listen up, Daniel, a godly man who distinguished himself with his lifestyle, with his godly values. MICAIAH was threatened and told not to give a true prophecy from God. Why? Because other 400 fake prophets are deceived here. They are told him lies, calling it prophecy, you see. When you are the lone person, the single person, against 400 prophets. That takes courage. That's intimidating, right? Let's go to Judges chapter 6, verse 30. And here is another classic case of intimidation. Judges 6, 30. This is the story of Gideon. Then the men of the city, they said to Joash, Joash is the father of Gideon, bring out your son that he may die, because he has torn down the altar of Baal, and because he has cut down the wooden image that was beside it. You see, they were idol worshippers. And God said, Gideon, I'm going to use you, but I need to clean you up first. So destroy the family idol. He did it, and the altar united against him and said, he had to die, but of course he did not die. The Lord delivered Gideon. The world will scare you to tear you away from God. If you're a child of God, a disciple of Jesus Christ, and you're feeling the heat in your workplace or in your family, hold on. Hold on. Don't give up, please. Do not give up. The world will scare you to tear you away from God. Don't let them. Amen. How do you overcome the world's system? The world's godless values. Remember, for our proclivity to sin, the Bible says we should run from last lesson. But this time the Bible says refuse. You have to refuse. This is the kind of renegade behavior that God encourages. God is proud of us when we dare to be different for Him. This is the kind, listen now, I will say this slowly. This is the kind of resist party or obstructionist movement which the Holy Spirit will not stop any believer to join. You see, when the word says abortion is okay, and they ask you, and you say, according to my Bible, and I believe my Bible, the Bible says it's murder. That kind of resist party and obstructionist view is acceptable before God. When someone says, it's one fatherhood of God and brotherhood of men, we are all worshiping the same God. Don't you think, Josephine Zion? Oh, no. We are not worshiping the same God. According to the Bible that I believe, when you stand up against that kind of godless values, God is clapping, the angels are cheering for you. All right? We are to make a deliberate, conscious, Holy Spirit-inspired, Bible-supporting resistance to every value that does not align with the Word of God. The Bible is the foundation and the final authority of a believer. If it doesn't line up with the Word of God, it goes into the garbage. That's it. Regardless of the consequences of such a decision, you see, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego refused to bow down to an idol that the rest of the people of Babylon worshipped. You see, this disobedience earned them the wrath of Nebuchadnezzar, the king of Babylon. However, with God, it earned them a great praise. God came down into the furnace to which they were thrown, you see. And because of them, the king proclaimed that the God of heaven is the only true God, you see. Micaiah refused to become a member of the prophetic union of Israel. He refused to join the union. You ought to refuse joining the union too. I ought to refuse, you see. He was ridiculed, he was slapped, and jailed. He took it as part of his job, you see. He did not shrink nor shirk his godly value. Don't let them intimidate you. Oh, no. It is not an extraordinary thing for followers of Jesus to be like Micaiah. No, it's not. The Bible says it's a reasonable service, you see. It is expected of us. So, when you are being mocked, when you are being ostracized because of your godly views, biblical values, don't think, oh, I'm doing something so great and wonderful. Thank God for the grace that you are standing. But really, it's just a reasonable service, okay? We are expected to go through that as believers. Matthew chapter 10 verse 28. Matthew 10:28. And do not fear those that kill the body, but cannot kill the soul. But rather fear him who is able to destroy both soul and body in hell. We are talking about our Lord Jesus Christ. He's the one who is able to kill both the body and the soul and cast it into the lake of fire. And that individual will be in a conscious state of eternal punishment. That person will be feeling the fire, but will not die forever, you see. Decide to stand or deny and slide. You cannot be on both sides. No. You either stand for God or you stand for the world. So if you are a Christian and your Christianity is okay with everything that the Bible says is wrong, you are not a Christian. But that can change. So decide to stand or deny and slide. How can we recognize our external enemy, the world system? Number one, it's inviting. It uses fame or money as its watch this, recruiting tools to attract people into accepting ungodly values. It's infectious. It poses as the majority to convince, watch this, gullible individuals that ungodly values are popular with many people. You see, we have 2% of the population of the United States throwing themselves all over the place as if the rest of the country is into homosexuality or alternative lifestyle, you see. But it's to convince people that this is popular. So when they ask for your opinion, I'm not saying go about to condemn people. No, don't. God gives us choice. Whatever you choose, we choose you as consequences, you see. But when you are asked for your own opinion as a Christian, make sure you stand on the word of God. Amen. The world system is intimidating. It punishes and ridicules those who spread godly values. How can we overcome the world's godless values? Refuse. The Lord expects his followers not to conform to the way ungodly people behave or live. All right, as a believer, are you a MICAIAH Christian? That is a non-conformist to the God, to the values of the world, or you are a compromiser? Huh? Which one are you? While living in this world may not be a great experience for a MICAIAH Christian, Jesus promised us a lot of trouble in this world. He didn't say it's going to be easy. But we have the promised glorious future in heaven. Hallelujah. And that is our sustaining strength for the present moment. The world is fast passing away. I cannot tell you enough how fast the world is passing. We will soon go into eternity. Come, Lord Jesus. A MICAIAH Christian has rewards to look forward to in heaven. A compromising Christian has loss of reward and sorrow to look forward to. So choose your choice as a believer. Now, I've decided to talk to unbelievers a different way tonight. I want to take you into my world. I want to speak to you from my pain, okay? If you don't believe in Jesus, you're an atheist, you're a skeptic, or you think Jesus is a religion. No, he's not. It's a commitment, a relationship that you commit to. You commit to him. Like, I'm committed to my husband alone, you see. If you don't believe in Jesus and you're saying, what is she saying? Listen. About 4 or so days ago, I received one single phone call and it changed everything for me. The best of all my siblings, 3 words, is dead. And that changed everything. I didn't receive any warning, nothing, just a phone call. You can imagine the shock, the anger, the sadness, the sorrow. He was only 48 years old. Okay? But you know what? Through my pain, through my crying, when I remember that he was a believer, a follower of Jesus Christ, not a pagan Christian who was just going to church, I thank God. I'm not saying he went to heaven because he's a good man. He was good to me personally. But that's not the reason. He went to heaven because he committed his life to Jesus Christ. Who knows? I don't wish that for you. Honestly, I don't wish anyone to go through the pain of losing a loved one so close to them at such a young age. No. But who knows? Who knows? This may be your very last time that you see anybody alive. Where will you go when you close those eyes? There's heaven to gain and there's hell to shun. My wonderful brother is now in heaven. While I'm sad and crying, here I look up and I see through the pages of the Bible, I'm looking forward to the great reunion when we will all be together again and never to cry anymore. Can you sincerely sleep tonight as somebody who doesn't believe in Jesus and say, there's no problem. There's a hell to shun. I'm telling you. If you want to come to the Lord Jesus Christ, you want to give your heart to Him, commit to Him, like a woman commits to a husband in a marriage and a man commits to his wife in a marriage, a link is coming up. Follow that link and we will meet you there. All right? You have nothing to lose except hellfire. That's it. And then get a Bible, start reading the Bible from the Gospel of John and meet Jesus there one-on-one. Don't just take my word for it. No. All right? Let's pray. Father, thank you, Father Lord, through our Lord Jesus Christ, by the Holy Spirit, that in every situation, you always take the glory, even what the enemy meant for evil. And so, Lord, I want to thank you, sweet, blessed Holy Spirit, for speaking through me. I leave these people into your able hands. Speak to their hearts, O Lord. Comfort those who are sad and mourning. For those who are sick, Lord, heal them. And for those who are really sick spiritually, they have the sickness of the soul by not knowing you. Open their eyes, O Lord, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Let's say, I don't know if Jesus is going to come today, but if he doesn't come, I will see you next time. If Jesus has not split the sky open.